Hi, welcome back to our series of videos on migraine and science. In the previous video, we saw that your exposure to migraine risk varies over time, and when migraine risk reaches the threshold level, brain receptors get upset, and these upset brain receptors trigger migraine symptoms. Today, we will dig a bit more into migraine risk and migraine threshold. We will see how migraine risk evolves over time, but also, and this is much less intuitive, how the migraine threshold varies as well. Let's start with the changes in migraine risk level. Migraine risk level can change significantly over time. In the previous episode, I introduced the risk meter, this great tool that is unfortunately yet to be designed. It works pretty much like a bulb thermometer. The orange liquid displays the level of risk at any time, and the red line shows the migraine threshold. Here is the risk meter reading at 10 a.m. We will slide it along the day to see how risk exposure evolves. From 10 a.m. to 4 p.m., it decreases. Here is the risk meter reading at 4 p.m. And from 4 p.m. to 10 p.m., risk exposure increases. Here is the risk meter reading at 10 p.m. Let's have a look at this again, but this time we will draw a graph that will follow the risk meter reading along the day. When we remove the risk meter, we see exactly how risk exposure varied that day from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. Let's add two axes. The vertical axis represents the risk, and the horizontal one is time. The risk exposure graph reaches the migraine threshold sometime between 4 p.m. and 10 p.m. At that time, symptoms appear. Before that, whenever the graph is below the migraine threshold, there are no symptoms. Stay below the threshold to remain free of symptoms. We saw on the graph that migraine risk varies very frequently. Exposure to migraine risk varies pretty much all the time. We can reasonably expect hourly variations, as shown on this example over a three-week period. Let's now focus on migraine threshold. Quick reminder, when migraine risk reaches the migraine threshold, brain receptors get upset and they trigger migraine symptoms. Now, back to the migraine threshold. The migraine threshold is tied to brain receptor sensitivity. The more sensitive the brain receptors, the lower the tolerance to upsetting migraine risk. Thus, the lower the migraine threshold. The migraine threshold is unique to each of us. It is our maximum tolerance to migraine risk. It is naturally low or high and should be quite stable over time. Diseases may change brain receptors' sensitivity. Medical treatments as well, either as a side effect or on purpose. Best example, the purpose of migraine prevention medical treatments is to increase the migraine threshold. Talk to your doctor for more information on preventive medication. Growing old may change how sensitive your brain receptors are. Events such as accidents, trauma, or other sources may significantly change the sensitivity of your brain receptors. Such changes may be temporary. For instance, migraine prevention drugs temporarily increase the migraine threshold. Or they may be permanent. They may be brutal, for instance, in case of an accident, but they are not so frequent. Migraine threshold changes span over months when taking preventive medication, over years when aging, and events are usually even less frequent. On this example, there is a sharp drop following an accident 20 years ago. Then a significant increase due to preventive medication from 2003 to 2009. And then the threshold slowly increases due to aging. Risk exposure changes all the time. In comparison, the migraine threshold is pretty stable. Preventive medication can help you raise the threshold and avoid symptoms. You may want to ask your doctor for more details. Let me know in the comments about your experience in risk and threshold changes. In the next video, we will dig into risk factors, also known as triggers, although by now, we know that they do not trigger anything. See you next time.